And the next team is SA13, consisting of Trinetra, Shahana R, G.A. Navya Sri, and Chaitra Nakaraj. So, SA13, your time starts now. Please unmute yes, yourself and your guest, and the rest, please mute. Some interference going on in SA13.
Good morning to the jury panel. Let me introduce myself. I'm Sahana R and my group mates are Trinetra, Navya and Chaitra. Let me, 1 second. Yes, let me start with our concept. It's basically the diamond and the faintone. Since the Gujarat is the hub of diamonds and faintone represents their culture and both carries the pride of the state, this gave us the opportunity for the unfolding possibilities such as the sharp design and the use of the colors. Coming to the execution, from both diamond and faintone, VVDT is a strategy which represent vibrant, striking, and liveliness. To give justice to our strategy, we chose steel frame and polycarbonate panels as the skin of the structure. As we all know, the site location is Kanderi in Gujarat. According to the site analysis in the brief, the site is an agricultural land which comes under the gradual development with moderate traffic. And the water body in the southwest creates the microclimate, which is a pro element in the site. The topography of the site has the terrain which creates the natural drying line. And the site selection is according to the pro climate, the maximum wind direction, and also the major accessibility to the hospital.
To continue with master plan, basically there are three main blocks, namely pandemic, inpatient, outpatient block, along with the small doctor residential block. And there are three parking facilities on ground. When one is for residents and the staff members, and another is for a patient's parking. Each accommodates 50 bikes and 50 cars respectively. And also there is one separate parking facility for ambulance beside the outpatient block where nearly 15 ambulance can accommodate. And also there are four lanes which runs throughout the blocks where two lanes on the left is for entry and other two is for exit. And all blocks has a basement parking. And the center plaza has been used as a green space since in hospital, along with the patients, even visitors are present and there will be a constant flow of traffic. So in order to divert them, we have given large center green space with sitting in it. And each block has a separate entry and a drop-off point from where people can exit from vehicles. And outpatient block and inpatient block are interconnected through a bridge. And that's all for a master plan.
Yeah, let me explain about the pandemic block. It is a G+4 structure with the lower ground and a basement. The basement has the placed with the mortuary and the limited access to the mortuary, and also the services like HVAC system and all are present in the basement. Coming to the ground lower ground floor plan. There are the radiologies and the pathology laboratories. Everything is present in the lower ground floor plan. And also in the rear side of it is the services. The main entrance is through the ground floor plan, and also it has a separate emergency entry. In the front panel of the ground floor is the rapid COVID test space where the patient can just drop in there, give the test and leave from the drop-off spot and not enter the building since it's a pandemic block and it is the issues of the sanitization. Behind the rapid test block is the laboratory, which is divided into dry lab, wet lab and the exit point. In the pandemic block, the first floor, second floor, third and the fourth are all of the separate division of the seriousness of the COVID patients. The first floor comes with a general ward where there are asymmetric patients, and then the second floor is of the double sharing rooms, and then in the typical third and the fourth is the ICU blocks. And in the first floor and then the second floor is the other consultation spaces, because when there are COVID patients, they're not just is affected by COVID. There can be patients who have like a prior medical history. Hence, there is a consultation rooms provided in the first floor and also in the second floor. We have for the isolation for the medical staff and from the patients, we have provided the double corridor system, which will have the negative pressure level will be used to for the isolation and also for the sanitization. For that duct, it will be in the rarer side of the building.
Okay, coming to inpatient block, there are total 8 floors, and the vertical section, vertical circulation is carried by 7 lifts and 2 firefighting staircase and 2 service lifts. Basement. Basement has 2 entries, service entry and ambulance entry, and it also has 4-wheeler and 2-wheeler parking. X-ray and radiology rooms are placed in the basement so that to avoid people getting affected. And for the upper basement, in the upper basement, we provided laundry service to the rarer side, auditorium, CT scan, ultrasound scan rooms, pharmacy, waste management, and canteen. In the ground floor, to the rarer side, we provided a canteen to the rarer side, and office and mortuary to the left side of the block, so that people coming from outside can also access the place. I mean, can also go to the mortuary. First floor. In the first floor, there is doctor's office, nurse station, toilets, chemo, waiting area, etc. In the second floor, there is doctor's office, consultation rooms, and general ward. In the third floor, all the OTs and ICUs are placed. In the fourth floor, same ICUs, OTs, and one-bedded rooms are there. In the fifth floor, spa, one-bedded rooms, and that's it.
Coming to outpatient block, it is of a G+2 building with the basement, and the basement has a service entry and parking also, whereas it also has a X-ray located in it, together with the water supply and HVAC services and all. And first floor, ground floor, it has 2 entries, one for main entry and another one is emergency entry. From emergency entry, it leads to emergency ward, and all the consultant rooms were located in the ground floor, along with a CT scan and blood test. And coming to the first floor, we have physiotherapy and meditation, along with the doctor of office and nurse station, along with the ICU and OTs in the first floor. Coming to the second floor, we have wards, general wards for both men and women separated. That's all.
Coming to the residential block, there is a residential block which is placed right beside the COVID block. To only doctors working there can access the residential block. This residential block has around 20 houses. And coming to the structural details, as our concept is diamond and fenton, we use materials like architecturally exposed structure steel, prefabricated materials, and polycarbonate panels to achieve a desired structure. Architecturally exposed steel frames are used as a binding material for the polycarbonate panels. Use of steel hollow columns beams helps in the speed up the construction and also rapid fixing of the prefabricated concrete walls. As polycarbonate panels are used for play of lights inside the building, these are connected to the steel frames. The polycarbonate panels are aesthetically pleasing and for whole structure and also effective insulating material. Precast concrete walls and slabs. These walls are used as both interior and exterior surfaces. As hollow core precast concrete slabs are much lighter than massive solid slabs of equal strength, has a great unobstacle span, which provides large open spaces. And these are the six views of OTs, waiting area, ICU, and lobby area.
As my teammates explained, our structure possesses the following qualities. Since we use steel and polycarbonate panels, it gives a play of light inside the building throughout the day. This shows our strategy, where the vividity plays main role. And we also achieve fast construction by using polycarbonate panels, prefabricated panels, steel structure and precast concrete walls and slabs. And it is also suitable for both emergency and pandemic purposes. And it can also be converted into pandemic since each block has that capacity to withstand, and it can also be interconnected. And not just the structure, even the greenery and landscape plays important role in function on hospital. Hence, we were inspired by Petra Blazy's work, and we incorporated in our central plaza, and which makes interior and exterior connected.
We'll play our one second.
Can give the commentary if there is no audio background. Let me explain wherever required.
Yes, thank you.
So I hope you have finished your presentation. Yeah, SA 13. Have you finished your presentation and all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I would request now the juries. I would first ask Dr. Arup Sarkar for his question and answers.
I think here I find that the participants are a bit nervous while presenting and showing things. So don't get nervous. Can you kindly explain how you are separating out the COVID and the non-COVID patients in your plan? all the patients will not be COVID patients here in this. So how the COVID patients are taken out from the bunch and separated out. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Did you understand the question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Slide. There are separate entries for the COVID and inpatient.
No, you can show in the plan. You can show in the plan.
Yes, sir.
When a person is detected non-COVID.
Yes, sir. There is separate entry for the COVID block and the outpatient and inpatient block, sir.
No. You understand. When a patient comes, you know that whether he is COVID or non-COVID. So there will be a check and there will be RT-PCR checking and there will be waiting. And then after 6 hours, it will be declared that he will be COVID. So till that time, how the patient is moving, that I want to know.
Yes, sir.
Because you see, when the patients are coming to your hospital, they are not supposed to take the RT-PCR test elsewhere. So they're feeling ill and they are coming in. So this is the tackling situation, practical tackling situation, that how you are separating out COVID and non-COVID from the very beginning. Have you ever thought of it?
Yes, sir. There is a separate entry for the COVID block where they directly go to the COVID block without entering the other, without going through the other blocks. They will give a test and wait there. Once they get the result, they'll move back to the...
That area. You highlight that.
Yes, sir. We are showing.
Okay, so basically for the COVID block, what we have done is in the front panel, we have provided the quick rapid test. It's not for the pandemic, more than the patients, there are people who are going to give the test. So in the front panel, they're going to give the test and they're going to leave by the drop-off point. And the patients who are going to admit are going to will be inside, will be that building will be sanitized and it will be sealed. It will be not open for the public.
Before getting admission, who will decide that whether this person will be admitted or not? Suppose he is not having COVID, where he is waiting and the family members. The family members.
That's why
accompanying...
we have, sir. That's why in the ground floor, as I explained, the first floor, second floor, and the third and the fourth will be the wards. In the ground floor, it is only the consultation and then the laboratory, and the consultancy rooms are in the ground floor. So patients who are gonna get admitted will be in the first floor, and with the
so
double corridor
then,
system, the isolation
then,
will be
yes,
sealed.
Yes. Till then, both the unidentified COVID and the non-COVID patients, along with their family members, are staying in together in the lobby.
No, sir. No, the family members won't. That's
where
the as we know in the pandemic blocks, the family members won't be allowed for the safety of the safety of the medical staff. We have the isolation separate and then the medical staff corridor separate.
Then where is the waiting lounge or waiting space?
The ground is the consultation room.
Kindly show the space.
If they test positive, they'll get admitted.
With your card, sir, kindly show the space where the patients,
okay.
Mixed patients,
yes,
those who have just come, they're waiting. You know, what is the total strength of the area? The capacity
sir,
of the
almost, area? It can accommodate almost 50 people.
50 people only. And that's also yes. COVID and non-COVID combined. Because that time, their test results did not come out.
So the should test, be, to give the test is air? Outside. This is the panel where they'll give the test.
They will give
if
the
they're
test.
Not come
they,
from,
for,
they're not...
For six hours, won't. For 6 hours, those patients will not be admitted until they are proven either they are COVID or non-COVID. I think you are going away from the practicality. If you go to any hospital in your place, anywhere, this is the standard procedure.
Yes, sir.
And you did not realize the real standard procedure, standard operating procedure of the admission in the hospitals right now. Every hospital is carrying out. Anyway, thank you very much. No more questions.
Thank you, sir. Now I would request Ma'am Sukarna Dasgupta.
Yes, Trinetra and Shahana, you have and team, you have shown a presentation where you have, you said, separated out the blocks and other things. Tell me one thing, I don't have much questions. You have used steel in the structures and polycarbonate sheet. Are you talking about the red ones on the roof? Those are of polycarbonate sheets? Hello? I can't hear. No, ma'am.
It's not. Those are not the polycarbonate panels, ma'am.
So what are those polycarbonate panels?
They are in the front facade, ma'am.
Facade, okay. No, you had talked about some skylights also. So these are the skylights you're talking about.
These are the polycarbonate panels which which we can see in the elevation of the building.
Instead of glass, you could have used glass also. So instead of glass, you use polycarbonate, is it?
Yes, ma'am, because they are much stronger than glass and can be fixed easily.
Got stronger. Maintenance is again an issue. Anyway, that's a different issue, but you have used polycarbonate. See, your plans are so, tiny, we could not really, we could not see properly. So can you go into the plans once?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is a inpatient block. So I just can't see anything. Like these rooms inside, and you have, given a lot of space inside for corridor or what?
Because the stretcher to rotate and go inside the thing.
Can you just blow it up?
Yes, ma'am. As we can see in third floor,
there is the staircase and lift.
Okay.
Say third floor, where is the staircase and lift?
Yes, ma'am. In the fourth floor, as we can see, there are two staircases at the two sides of the building, and there are three lifts and four central lifts. Two are service and two are passenger lifts. And this third floor has ICU units, two ICUs, which is directly connected to the ICUs. Which is directly connected to the OTs. There are two OTs, which has dry lab, wet lab, and also changing room for the doctors. And every floor has a nurse station. And there are two bedded rooms in the third floor, and also which has toilets to that.
Anyway, so your basic planning is, the cores are on the two sides.
Cores are in the center. Yes, ma'am. Two sides and the center.
And also the center.
Yes, so, ma'am.
The whole, the part, maximum part is used in your the cores, right?
Yes,
ma'am. Only at the outside, some few rooms, as I can see, are there, isn't it?
So yes, ma'am.
The efficiency, you just check it out. I feel that it needs to be efficiency in planning. That's what I want to say. And the structure, can you go to the structure sheets once?
Yes, ma'am.
So you have used steel in your structure items only, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Anywhere else?
Columns, beams, and to join all those polycarbonate panels to keep them together, we are using steel.
Can you go into the section? Forget about structure. Can you go into the section once? Have you drawn sections?
Yes.
Not
yes,
these.
But they are real extreme.
And section of the buildings?
Yes, ma'am. We have to.
Why have you made it so small? Not visible. What is the height of the building? I mean, how much height have you taken?
Each floor is 3.5, ma'am.
Have you provided AC anywhere?
Ma'am?
AC.
Yes, ma'am.
AC, have you considered? Okay.
Yes, ma'am. We considered that.
So those AC ducts will go, or it may be the ductable split, because there is in your brief, so those things are there, those items are there, like whether AC will be considered or not. And so 3.5 meter height, if you are considering AC with ductable splits or whatever, so that may be a bit less. Anyway, that's all I think I can say. But you have made your plans very small and not really readable, and also sections. Okay, next time when you give, it has to be, you know, so that the other, whoever is seeing that, they are able to understand, because it is not readable at all. Okay, thank you.
Now, Dr. Deshmukh.
Yeah, no, I don't have any questions. I just wanted to tell them that, this is a presentation drawing. So don't treat your plans as working drawing plans. Because what I see on those little plans is all the dimensions all around. I think when you're presenting in a competition, it should be a presentation drawing rather than a working drawing. So that is what I would like to make a comment. And all other things seem to be all right. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Bhattacharya.
Not much of a comment. Only, again, a very common person's perspective. Somehow, I felt that the central area or landscaping, etc., got slightly more preeminence compared to the main project. So that was how I perceived as a very common person. And overall, I would have preferred maybe this polycarbonate as well. Slightly, I am a bit apprehensive. I would have preferred something different. But you have tried with steel, etc. Some thought on modularization or prefabrication would have further enhanced the things. Otherwise, it's okay. Looks good. Thank you.
Thank you, team. So you have heard what juries have advised you.